You know, I'm getting a little scared here. Coda's made some updates. Haven't talked about Coda in a while, and I think Notion, you gotta step your game up. Gonna make a completely blank document. Something that's cool is that you can do this now. You can actually edit the separator, which is like dividers in Notion, and change the line style to a bunch of different things. Notion's got one of these. Coda's got six of these. But that's not the main thing. Coda decided, hey, let's go all in and make a Microsoft Teams integration. As someone who used to use Microsoft Teams at my work, I'm really upset because you can have a full-fledged system now between Coda and Microsoft Teams. So in order to make that happen, let's go to the top right here and look for packs. So Microsoft Teams, then press load pack. So if you have the enterprise version, what you're basically going to be able to do is make it so that you can have all of your documents interact with Microsoft Teams and go to the point of even requesting updates from there to Microsoft Teams, which when you're thinking about it, just allowing to push messages to a chat app from the database with buttons and stuff like that, this is why Notion needs a button feature. I mean, they've already gotten to the point at Coda where you can trigger things with webhooks. But now we have an entire integration with the software that is one of the most important ones on the market. You see here it says notify team, good morning, today is Friday, and you can even add specific people. It has me worried because there is a distinct difference between a real integration, like what Coda is doing, and what Notion is doing. Notion is one of those applications where it is so close, but so far away in many other ways. When it comes to being able to easily interact with Teams from Notion through the chat app, all we got is that Slack integration, which is meh, to say the least. And let me tell you this, first and foremost, you can't do recurring tasks. You can't have button features. And while the Slack integration that is there can do something to provide project updates, it is not connected with Teams, which is one of the main applications that a lot of enterprise companies use. If you're not going to be connected with what other big companies are going to use, you're going to have a problem maintaining market share with Teams in general. Because I think Teams is actually a really great solution. You can call people from Teams. You can message people from Teams. Heck, it basically becomes being able to call everyone through a specific type of app on your phone. You have your entire calendar integrated there. And while it's not as good as Google Calendar, it is something that works. The screen sharing experience is better on Teams. And it is something that enterprise companies are going to use for security purposes more often than Slack. So you not being able to connect to it, but other apps being connected to it is just bothering me. Because obviously there is the pack in here for Slack where you can send updates and reminders from your doc, just like you can do pretty much in Notion. You can post specific messages in Slack using this button feature, which just makes it completely next level because we just don't have a button feature in Notion. And then when it comes to something as nice as Coda's Google Calendar integration, even though Teams doesn't have a good calendar, say a company uses Google and Slack in order to communicate. Well, you have a Google Calendar integration with Coda that just works. You can add a task with something like this with the button to the specific events that are occurring on your calendar, like your daily stand-up or your lunch and learn. And they even have templates to get you pre-built set up into making this happen. When are we going to let this kind of stuff happen for team use in Notion? Like, for example, as a team member of my small business who uses Gumroad, the thought of having an integration where you can manage your Gumroad memberships, subscribers, sales, and more, considering that is a big part of my revenue, how could I not consider using Coda as an option over Notion? I'm a Notion user who sells Notion templates, which is one of the primary things that people use Gumroad for. And Notion's main competitor, using the power of this Pack Studio and the better integration setup that they have, where they're going to bring this integration to their software. Like, how ironic would it be if people who sell Notion templates use Coda because it's an easier solution for integrating with different things like Gumroad? They're doing some really nice things at Coda, and I don't want to hate on Notion too much, but link previews are only going to get you so far when you have your competitors doing an entire movement towards making integrations better by empowering the user. Empower us. You guys got this. Just do something about it. If anyone shares my frustrations, let me know in the comment section down below. And check out this video on how to actually improve your productivity.